incrementally. So we're not going to go from a £10 charge now to whatever, I'm not going to put a figure on whatever figure that goes to, it's going to be incremental. So there's an awful lot of work involved in just bringing the people to the free and implementing the charge, as well as implementing new schemes. And Ron was quite right, actually, that the amount of cars now on the road, so we have got areas where before there are areas in my ward that wouldn't have thought in a million years about residents' parking schemes. But they are now starting to think because of the sheer volume of cars. So my question is the size of your department, and are you going to be able to cope? And how long do you think it will take to implement the charge where it's free at the moment? Thanks, Keith.
Thank you for you, Chairman. I'm pleased that there's a recognition that there are issues around resourcing. And this, subject to approval by cabinet, I can foresee there will be a lot of objections to this, as you say. I don't quite understand. It's the right of people to object. It's part of the process. It's the legal process that we go through. The staff that I have, currently it's fully committed to delivering the existing workloads that we've got, which is around constituency committee work, capital programme work, road safety work, all these sorts of issues, and just keeping up with the day-to-day correspondence. So I think, subject to cabinet approval, I would be hopeful, and we would have to phase it in some way, so we'd have to work out the phasing. We couldn't do a big bang for 10,000 permits, so we have to work out some kind of phasing. We're hope, subject to cabinet approval, that we'll be able to get underway with some consultation with the initial phase within 6 months, something like that. If that's satisfactory.
Thanks, Keith. That's fine. Thank you. Any more questions? Thanks, Keith. Can I ask the members now to agree the recommendation? And I think what we'll do is we've got some costings, we'll ask you to come back and explain the costings, please, before they're implemented.
Okay.
Is that agreed?
Dave,
you did.
I'm just going to move, Chair.
Have we got a seconder? Thanks, Steve. Agreed? Thanks very much, Keith.
Thank you.
And Sean's sitting at the back of the room, I'd like to thank Sean for his wisdom on this. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. If I may just say, I was very remiss in not thanking as well Mike Lester, who did a great job for us.
Thanks.
I know he did say officers, but Mike also needs a mention of him.
Chris, thanks very much for that. Yes, it does. A lot of what Mike does goes unrecognised, particularly by me, I might add. So thanks for that.
That might be deliberate, Chair. Thank you.
Right, we'll move on swiftly to item 5 on the agenda, which is the road surface update. Julie Barnes, thank you. And Sean.
And also outlines how the condition of our network is assessed and
inspections are undertaken on slow moving vehicles. And this enables our best value performance indicators to be produced. Both types of surveys are actually carried out after we've undertaken that year's maintenance programme, which enables us to reflect the investment that we've put in for that year. So the performance of Wirral's network for the past 6 years is shown on table one in the report that you've got in front of you. And the percentage that's recorded in the table indicates the
test. The treatment was poor. The contract had accepted that they were responsible and that the road would be resurfaced completely. Now that hasn't happened. They patched it and they've been allowed to do it. No one's challenged them. I've reported it to the street scene and as far as I can see they've walked away from it. But paying good money to have this work done, they're not doing it correctly. And even when they come back for a second chance at putting it right, they don't do it correctly then. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. Again, I'm involved on a day-to-day basis, but similar to that tonight as well. I can make some inquiries about that for you tomorrow.
Thanks, Chair. The book report does indicate a lot of figures. My first disappointment is why 10 kilometres. My batteries and my calculator have never gone because I've had to 0.621 in all which I've learned how to do it. The 1% looks good on the A and B and seeing on classified roads. But when you put it into miles, 80% of the roads on the Wirral are unclassified, and they're the ones that we as councillors go usually get all the phone calls for. So it's 80% of the roads that are the ones that are troubling us, and the 6%, when you put that on the 80% of our roads, that's 33 miles we've got that's not white. And because these figures are, 10 months old, I think most of us from looking around our walls, so a lot of the roads that you go into and you know that your residents are pointing out look at that but and there's very little we can say. So whilst these figures are good and they're talking about the national, that doesn't really affect us, but we're worried about the 6% of the 80%, which is 33 miles, which we need to do something about. And I don't know if you care to comment on why it isn't kilometres. Okay.
Well, I think it's in kilometres.
The 6% is it does reflect a fair amount of the new classified network. And certainly the new schemes that we're doing this year, although there's never been enough budget to actually carry out the new schemes that we've been doing, I think there has been some concentration on the new classified network. This figure, again, not just nationally, but within the Merseyside region,
how 6% is only actually like the critical stuff, and within their 20% is the critical stuff and some other stuff. Who makes that judgment? Has everybody got the same thing? Like a pothole has to be so many meters, millimeters, or whatever the ruling is on that. Are there national guidelines that say at this point this road has to be repaired?
Chair, comprehensive report that explains everything in detail. On the amounts of money we're actually spending on the highways at the moment, the budget set, and we all remember when the budget proposal was set by the Red Group. It's a fixed amount, so there's no extras. We've had some little bits from central government for potholes, because the roads are in such a bad state. But my question is in relation to the answers that have already been given. As an authority, we through planning allow more roads to be developed each year on the local authority. How long will it take before we start to get to the state that, as you said, we're looking at this at the moment? I have been away quite a few times. This is more than that's all I'm going to say. Given that we're set with a fixed amount of money to spend on the highways, and we do increase the amount of highways we have annually, because we put more roads on every time we allow the housing state to be built. That would mean then depletes and gets less to spend on highways. So my question is, how rapidly would the decline be given that we're
tax situation, isn't it? Because the pot is shrinking rapidly, without mentioning the way it costs, which I won't mention. But the pot is shrinking drastically. We're having, as a council, we're having to build, as there's a great need there to build more houses, which is going to attract more vehicles into all our areas, no matter where we are on the Wirral, because there's a desperate shortage of housing in this country. So it is, it's an ever diminishing pot that we're trying to stretch to keep our roads in good order, and it is a problem. But I would like, we will be coming back to this when we work out the work programme for this year, when the spokespersons and myself and the vice chair meet. And I think this is an area of great concern, I think, which all committee members have voiced tonight, which we do, because it's a difficult one. The departments are shrinking, the budget's shrinking, we've got the roads, and there's more cars daily on our roads, and the parking on pavements, which is diminishing the pavements greatly. And it is a major concern, which I think the committee we should be looking at again this year, because the departments itself, technical services, are doing a terrific job. But we know the demands and the way, and I'm concerned about our road services, no doubt about that.
Just come back and say
very quickly, Dave, because Anita wants to come back.
I completely agree with the comments you made about what the staff here for us. They work absolute wonders, given what we're given. The one point I would make is that I made a comment in relation to the Wirral Peninsula, not my particular work.
Anita.
Thanks, Chair.
Just
I think I'd just really like to reiterate about the quality of the work that's been done by Balmutal. And it surprises me really that there are quality checks in place before that job's actually signed off. I think the other thing that my residents constantly ask is, when there's two potholes next to one another, why is one repaired and the other one is not repaired? Only for them to come back a week later or 2 weeks later and then repair the other home. So I'll ask that question on behalf of the residents. And also, the other matter really is, once our officers go out at night, they identify that there's an issue with part of the road and we get a white circle around the area. Why does it then take so long to actually fill that pothole?
Engineer speaking.
Chair, as I said, I'm not involved
to and fro in about it's not our cost, it's your cost.
Yeah, there will always be some items on that contractual laying materials, the material supplier or something else, or temperature or drainage or something like that. And we need to argue our cost and make sure that we keep enough attention back on these individual schemes that if they don't do the work, then we have the money to use the other contractors. And there is a facility with the contractor.
My concerns are that, from what I'm hearing, is that there are a lot of problems with it.
I think it's considered this, I wouldn't disagree with that.
And do we have to fax any figures for all those?
Yes, we do.
Can they be released?
Yes.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Bruce.
Thank you, Chair. I'd just like to know, I believe that motorways are covered by highways and departments. A roads, B roads are covered by local authority. Is that correct?
Yes,
that's from the question, that's part of it. So,
I was going to maintain motorways.
Okay. Now, I had an email from a resident who complained about when you come off the M53 motorway, the Morton Spur, that the road on the roundabout itself was a carbon company and he rides a motorcycle. And his wheel got stuck in it and merged through his motorcycle. I wrote to Scrutiny to ask who's responsible for the actual roundabout. Is it highways or is it local authority? Never got an answer. Can you answer that for me?
Yes, I can. The roundabout belongs to council.
Council, thank you.
Are there any other questions? Thank you. Thanks, Sean. Item 6 on the agenda is the Liverpool City Region, and as all members are aware, we can have an update every meeting. And Rosemary can't make it tonight, she's got family commitments, so in her stead, we've got a very able deputy here to my left, Alan Evans. So, Alan, thank you.
Thanks, Chair. Just a very quick update on what's going on with the Cllr then. All bits are set out in the report, but just to run through some headlines. Everyone will know on the 4th of May, the Cllr appointed a new natural mayor, or deputy natural mayor, for a period of 3 years, but it's 2020. The first annual meeting of the combined authorities was held at the end of May 26th, where a number of portfolios were handed out to members of the combined authority, and there was also one new member of that was co-opted, which was the Pilgrim of the Transport Authority, and then following that in June, further co-opted member joined Jim Kendi, the Crime Commissioner. So that forms the part of the Natural Mayor's Cabinet, and the paper just goes on to talk about the members of the Mayor's advisory team, and also what lead officers are taking responsibilities across the local authority areas as well. There is a review in the paper of the CA progress of 16-17. I won't go through that, but if anyone has any questions, I'll be happy to take them.
Any questions arising from our succinct?
In relation to housing and public service reform, will there be anything happening there than what I read in the record?
From a point of view, Liverpool are still taking that portfolio, so there's no significant changes to the portfolio we set out. So, and the lead officer of my pay will set out.
Thank you,
Chair.
Thank you
all.
I'd just like to say on this, I've got a real concern about since Steve Robin was elected, and when the bid went into the LCR, or the LCR to central government, there was nothing in the bid. The central government made it clear that there was no money for capacity and resources. And I think it's been very evident since the Metro Mayor was elected. When you look at Manchester, now Manchester is light years ahead for various reasons. And we had a picture of Andy Burnham, who was elected as the Metro Mayor for Greater Manchester, with Manchester area, all the regions pay into a pot, and they have done for quite some time because they are ahead of us on the game office. I think what's going to happen in the future to cover the resources is that the six local authorities, and it's something for us as a scrutiny committee to look into, and I'll come on to that report in a minute, not that there's very much to report on that. But I think what might have to happen in the future is that the six regions, the six authorities in the region, are going to have to come together and think about, and again, in ever diminishing resources, I might add, we're going to have to start looking at a resource for the new position of Metro Mayor. So that's one to consider, I think, as a committee. Ron?
Yeah. Folks in Shane didn't attend the meeting last night, but Steve Rodham attended, and he did speak about the issue around staffing. The interim mayor's travel got some support staffing for him. He's in the process of recruiting staff. His comment to the Labour members last night is not about quantity, it's about quality. And he envisages the staff that he would appoint would be of a better quality. Manchester, it would be a better quality than what Manchester have got. It's just that Andy Bainham inherited all them staff that were already in place working for Manchester to part of the collective. There's a lot more authority within Manchester, on the Greater Manchester region, which we've pointed in his own Merseyside. And Steve was quite comfortable with the position he's in. He recognised that obviously the didn't have any support from the start, but it is now being put in place advertising and recruiting. So things have moved on. It might be at some point what I would like to invite the mayor here to give you an update where he is to the committee. But I'm that's the situation that I was explained to me last night. So thanks for good to speak.
Thanks, Rob. Thanks for that. That's most helpful. Just for the other members, Steve Rowland came over. We had a group meeting last night, and Steve Rowland came over to give us an update. And that might be something that the other party might think about inviting them to give an update at one of your group meetings. But is there any more questions? Because that will bring us nicely onto item 7. Steve?
Bruce.
Bruce, sorry. Bruce.
Thanks, Mike. When Steve Rotherham was here last night, he didn't mention about a lot of the distractions taking place between the battling that's going on between Steve Rotherham and his counterpart, Joe, did he, by any chance? I think that's distracted a great deal from the city region.
Okay.
I can confirm to you, Joe, that no mention was made.
No. And that. The question you've asked is there are distractions over in Liverpool. Steve Rotherham, I wasn't at the meeting last night, but Steve wouldn't have mentioned that. But the overtly political inference you're making from that, Bruce, is no, that's not a distraction to the new Metro Mayor. No, it's out of context, and really.
Chair, is that acting?
No, these are things we can come back to, and that's why I make sure, and we have made sure in the last couple of years, that we've always had an update, because I think it is important. So I think it brings it on to item 7, which is the scrutiny report. And what I can say on that is that we haven't met yet, and we've got dates. We've got a development meeting on July the 19th, where we're going to discuss the issues that we've mentioned tonight, leading on to the first scrutiny panel meeting, which is on the 26th of July. So things, as far as scrutiny is concerned, will move forward this month, because of those two meetings. Certainly the first meeting will be an all-day meeting in Manara, when we'll discuss what we've discussed here tonight. So when we come back in September, I'm sure there will be a lot more to report than all we're talking about really here now is the supposition. There will be more meat on the bone when we come back to meet in July, in September rather. But if the committee would like, we could invite the Metro Mayor over to do a presentation, and if his diary is free, I'm sure he will be more than willing to come over. So that's item 7. Dave?
On that point, sir, if he does have the time to move, it would be beneficial to invite all councillors, not just this way.
Yes, well, we can, yeah, by all means. Yeah. Is there anything else on item 7 on the scrutiny report that I've just very able to give? We'll move on to item 8. So this is the committee members' briefing pack, which I hope everybody has read. And can I ask for members to note the briefing pack, please? I hope that's particularly helpful to any new members.
Agreed.
Is that agreed?
Yeah.
Thank you. Item 9, quarter four